Hi, welcome to Name of the Lord 777 Ministry, Flat Earth Defined by Yin and Yang, Aeons Timing, Fibonacci, and Firmaments. This should be an exciting video of many first-time items on the YouTube channel. I'm not sure how long they'll let this stay up. I pray you'll watch it and understand. Flat Earth Design, Yin and Yang Defined. Remember, Pangaea is the start of Aeon 1 when the Earth was together prior to the time of the separation. You see the Fibonacci curve? That's how the Earth expands. And it has two focal points. One, around Giza and the Russian North Pole in Moscow, and the other in Hawaii and the Alaskan North Pole. Just an amazing revelation that we were able to put together in this last days. God unveiled it maybe at 3 a.m. in the morning one night. How exciting. We can explain it to you. These are secrets that might be known in the Mason Temple, but I don't know. There you see the Alaskan North Pole, the Hawaiian Islands, you see the Russian North Pole, and you see Mount Sinai, all on the 137-degree movement line for the North Pole. The Giza Pyramid also in that same area. Now let's look at the 2592 Aeon. Let's see what it turns the clock 36 degrees at every aeon. We start at zero and we go to 2592, years from creation. Then we go to 72 degrees and we go to 5184 a.m. which is years from creation. Then we go to 108 degrees, aeon 3, 7776. So on and so forth. 144 degrees, aeon 4, 10368. 180 degrees, aeon 5, 12968 a.m. Then aeon 6, 1555 to September 11, 1285 BC. Amazing these numbers. And then aeon 7, 18144. Aeon 8, 288 degrees, 2736 a.m. Aeon 9, 23328. And now we're around the precession one time, 2598 a.m. November 6, 363 a.d. 36 degrees more and we get March 26, 776 a.d. 72 degrees from the top of the 12 o'clock, we get Aeon 12, 31104 a.m. Exact number of verses in the Bible. Now we're at 108, and we hit the 696 a.m. And finally, we finish 144 degrees, 36288 a.m. years. The year 2013. Isn't that amazing? Let's look now at the 5184 Aeon. This is my favorite, and I think this is the way God has set this up. The reason I think that is because the Giza Pyramid is angled 5184 degrees. Now, if you'll notice, this is just double the sizing of the 2592. 2592 times 2 equals 5184. So we have all the same degrees. Less, twice as much, and we have just less stops on the Aeon. So now we're Aeon 4 and 2736. Now we're at 12 o'clock and 25920, great year. November 6, 363 AD, at 72 degrees, we have Aeon 6, 3104 AM. Remember the number of verses in the Bible. And finally, the Aeon stop at 144, Aeon 7, 36 through 88. Let's now look at the expansion of the firmament. The expansion of the firmament starts in Aeon 1. It expands to Aeon 2, which we will call the second heaven, which equals darkness. And then Aeon 3, we will call paradise. Aeon 4, sun and moon luminous. This is where the sun and moon live. Finally, firmament. The fifth heaven is called the prison of the fallen angels. And finally, the sixth heaven, the archangel Hermes. And the seventh heaven, the archangel Seraphim and cherubim Hermes. And the eighth heaven, Mazala, Hebrew name. Not much is known about that. The ninth heaven is the constellation Hebrew, and finally the 10th heaven, God's throne. Now, to know that we're right about this, we take the doorway of the Mason Temple in Philadelphia, the most powerful temple in all of America, mostly modern, and you can see the firmaments from the black of the darkness of number 2, which is where we are called Aries, and expanding out to the sun. The 10th firmament. This took a lot of work, people, to uncover this, and I'm sure I'll get to die for these secrets that I'm giving to you. But I pray you'll use it to find your way into heaven. I'm not worried about that. When you die, you gain. And we will be in the millennium. I hope you will be understanding the firmament. We take the great year 25920. Divided by, in this particular case, 6. Now, if you look at the yellow realm, you see that's where the Yellow Submarine of the Beatles existed. And the parody song that they sing. You note that the second heaven is darkness. But don't forget, the third heaven is paradise. Here, the Seventh-day Adventists talk about paradise on earth, and it does exist. It's just it's darkened by all the demon forces. Now here we're going to take Aeon Fibonacci 0, 1, and 2, and Aeon 1, and you're going to see the tilting of the globe, not the globe, the tilting of the flat earth. And when I say tilting, the firmament, okay? So we go from 0 to North Pole 1, North Pole 2, these are the firmaments, these are the aeons, and there you see it, the expansion is clear, it went from 0 to 1980 miles, David Flynn died for that number. Now we look at the next series of expansions, we go from 0 1980 to 1980, 3960 to 5940 to 9900. Then, these are the years on the bottom that are transpiring from the beginning. Look at that 3168 number. That is the dimension of Jesus, Lord Jesus Christ. Look at these amazing numbers, the firmament 5 to firmament 10, where the throne of God is. Look at the Aeon numbers down below. How exciting. We have the sizes along the top. And we have the locations. The ANP stands for Alaska North Pole, the NP North Pole, the RNP stands for Russian North Pole. So you know where the throne of God is at any one time. It is said that Elijah travels around the flat earth 3 times before the truth can get out of the starting block. It's so true. They have taught so many lies, they've supplied so many globes to every school and all over the world to teach the globe theory. that they developed after they broke into the Hall of Knowledge in the Giza Pyramid. When I say they, it's the Masons, Jesuits, Illuminati, and their friends. So we look at Aeon 1 through Aeon 2 and 2 through 5, and we look at the summary. You see the data that we're giving you? This is first time ever on the internet. First time ever, folks, developed right here, blessed by the Father in Heaven. Late third aeon, we're in Russia. Fourth aeon, we're back to the North Pole. Fifth aeon, Alaska. Check out Franklin Graham studies, you'll see that that bears out. The sixth aeon, we're right where we are, and then we expand to the Russian North Pole for the millennial time period. How exciting to have this explained in the last days. Don't believe CNN. Satan wants you to believe CNN. CNN has no truth. They're owned by the Illuminati. Only five people own all the media in the world. How can you trust them? Look at this revelation after revelation that God has shown us. We only receive this because we search, we ask, and we receive. The growth of the firmament and the movement even shows the concept that Adam and Eve were kicked out of the garden, and that's when the firmament moved to Russia, and they could no longer enter the Garden of Eden location at the North Pole. Finally, we finish with this seventh Aeon, and that is called the end. Seven is BNN for end, and that is the millennial period where we will expand into the 33 continents that Admiral Byrd clearly told us on live TV. You'll see it on our webpage. God bless you as you study out these truths. Forget the globe lie. It may take 3 days. It took me 3 days of unprogramming to believe the flat earth, but it's all biblical. Okay, here's your 1, 2, 3 Fibonacci expansions. Now, we're going to talk about the megaliths that are built in history. During Aeon 1 and 2, The first two cycles of the Fibonacci sequence. Remember Fibonacci 0, 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, etc. You add the previous number. That's how you get the Fibonacci series. And this is how we take the expansion. We go from 0 to 1980. And the next expansion is also stays the same, 1980, because it's 0, 1, 1. Do you get it? I hope you get it. If you don't get it, it may cost you eternity. It's not that hard. Pray about it. God will show you. Here we have the truth. It's amazing. We start in the North Pole. We go to the Russian North Pole. Look at how that's in line with Mount Sinai. This is called a portal. This is a secret gate that God can come down to the earth in along this 137-degree line from the North Pole. The Alaskan North Pole is lined up also. They're 1980 miles away from the North Pole. The Russian North Pole and the Alaskan North Pole. Be excited. Take 1.618 and multiply it by 360. And what do you get? 222.5. That's the phi angle or God throne angle. The Masons love co-opting God's numbers. 222 is one of their favorites. The processional 25920 is God's wristwatch, counting down to the last days. Aeon 1 and 2 are 1980 miles in diameter, with the pole star directly above in the North Pole. Now let's look at the Mercator map. Think of 1563 and the Garden of Eden, and this You can see 1569, excuse me. Here we are verified as the Mercator Man, the descendants of King Arthur, who grew up 4,000 individuals off in 12 boats in 576 AD. The descendants returned to King of Norway and repeated the description of the North Pole. They said there was four lands that extended to the 87th latitude that makes it 1980 miles in diameter to the rim of the mountains that surround the Garden of Eden. Presently, there were pygmies who were noted to live in the land, and evidence also of ships in other areas. Note, the United Nations or the Beast System blocks us from going to the North Pole and Antarctica, so you cannot discover the minerite rock that makes our North Pole magnetic. They also describe the black minerite rock, which is the item that the descendants from King Arthur said would pull the nails right out of folks. That's how magnetic it was. And the water enters this chasm next to the minerite rock as a whirlpool. That is our ebb and flow of our tides across the world. Forget about the moon. There is no globe. No, they didn't have the moon. It's all bogus. It's all full of lies. The truth will set you free. Remember, the Aurora Borealis is the special lights that go down into the whirling whirlpool at the North Pole. It's possible that these are the, as the Bible describes, the fallen angels are light, and they could be the ones that are going in and out of the underworld, because that's where they live now. They live out in Antarctica and in the underworld. Enoch surely tells us that the reason they took Enoch out of the Bible in 1881 is so that you could not piece together these truths. And keep in mind, Copernicus came up with his laws in the 1500s, I think 1534. And he told those lies about the globe earth so that you lose your identity in Christ and think you're just a small speck in a huge, huge universe. But how not true that is. Don't forget Garden of Eden, 1981. Here's a nice ministry, the God Culture. They have done a nice job of explaining the Garden of Eden is located at the North Pole. But when Adam and Eve were kicked out, it's possible they moved to the Philippines. Very interesting article. Here is the United Nations flag, which clearly shows the flat earth and the ice wall surrounding it. Now let's look at Aeon 3, Binding Yoke and Division. There's the specifications that we have developed. No one gave it to us, no Mason gave it to us. We developed it from God's truth. Revelation of the last days. We will die for it also, possibly. Or, if God chooses, we will be hidden. We are going to try to hide. It says that the godly man will hide in the last days. Remember, the first firmament expands from 0 to 1980. And because of the Fibonacci 1-1, it stays 1980 for the next aeon. And finally, in the third aeon, it shifts to 3960. It expands by adding the first two 1980s together. Remember, during this time period, the Enoch describes the giants as being 11,000 and 250 feet tall, which I think is understandable how big they were and what they built. They built Gornaya, Sharia in Russia, and Baalbek. Stones that we can't move today. Here's the direction of the movement. Started in the North Pole, Eden, Adam and Eve were kicked out, and they were banished, and the firmament moved over Russia, where you couldn't actually get to Eden. Just backs up the Bible tremendously. During this period, the murderers were Baalbek, Stonehenge, and Gornea, Sharia. God's wristwatch, counting down to the last days, showed they are now at 15.552 a.m. Gregorian years from creation. You'll notice the clock in the lower right-hand corner is pointing right before we enter Leo. AM 3, as we've said before, 3960 miles in diameter, the red circle on the map. And the throne of God, of course, is located at the Russian Empire. AM 3, here is your major megalith still, first Baalbek, which is outside of Mount Hermon, where the fallen angels, 200 fallen angels, were banished to the earth. They mated with the human women and made giants. That's how they made Baalbek. Now, a pregnant woman stone for Baalbek in Lebanon weighs 1,260 tons. However, an area never talked about in Russia, Gornea Sharia, has megaliths that easily weigh 3,000 to 4,000 tons. Why don't we know this? Why are we not telling you the conclusion that we have right here? Why? Because they want to deceive you, so you'll choose the wrong Antichrist, the Antichrist of their choosing, versus the Christ of God's choosing. He will be back soon. During the third aeon, the additional firmaments stacked above the earth caused more pressure on the oxygen to push into the plants, and also the sun being out in the fourth firmament had to shine through these firmaments, and it cast a pink hue, and that made like a garden effect. You know how plants like pink light? So sure enough, the trees grew massively. These are 7-foot seeds. Wow. Aeon number 4. Now we expand. 4 BNM means message in here. The earth expands to 5940. Remember, 3960 plus the 1980. And now you have a green diameter circle. The third aeon firmament decays, and you grow into the 5940 mile diameter firmament over the present North Pole. The same thing will happen as the scroll rolls away and the great earthquake of seal number 6 takes place. During this time period, Chahokia in America was built. The Sun and Moon Pyramid in the Grand Canyon, you probably know nothing about, was built. And the Pyramid of Exion, the White Pyramid in China, was built. The reason these were built is there's a sweet spot around the firmament, which exists at 5% of the distance, just like the Giza Pyramid teaches us. Clock moves to Cancer, ready to go into Gemini. Remember, we're in Pisces, and we're ready to go into Aquarius. Aeon number 4, 5940 miles in diameter, the green circle. Make no apology for the graphics here. We've developed all this on our own. We don't have school books or college funds or fees paid by the government to develop all this. Look at all these megaliths explained during this time period. The Chahokia tribe, right there at the maximum solar eclipse point of August 21. You don't even know that. The Sun Pyramid of the Grand Canyon, the Hawaiian Islands, expanded at that time, and there it is at the north, the Xi'an Pyramids of China, right, were built at this time. This information is just amazing, and I'm in awe that God has used me to deliver that, with our family all in tow. Joseph's descendants moved to the Americas and lived in the Grand Canyon, building the Sun and Moon and Earth pyramids. Now remember, Joseph's descendants were infiltrated by the Nephilim. That's where they worship the sun and some of these pyramids. So know that the whole world was corrupt by the Nephilim. You can even see in the Grand Canyon Pyramid that the name Pati Perfura, the priest of On, is engraved in the temple at the Sun Pyramid in the Grand Canyon. Most of you don't even know you have a Sun Pyramid in the Grand Canyon, but it's all laid out like Orion. Why Orion? Well, that's for later discussion. The mystery of Joseph's descendants. Look at this article, April 5th, 1909. Why don't you know it? Because the Smithsonian has covered it up. They discovered this temple through the Grand Canyon at the lower rim and took all the artifacts and covered it up. It's just one massive cover up. You don't know anything. But now the Chahokia pyramids and Central America, the largest pyramid in America right now. Here in the bottom right, you see the Orion, and you see the layout of all the pyramids in the Grand Canyon, shaped in the Orion star. The White Pyramid of China was built in the skull there, Aeon. And there you see the picture in 1947. If you haven't connected the dots, many, many megaliths are built on the 19.47 latitude. 1947, of course, the year that Jesus, that Israel came back into the land. Now let's look at Aeon number 5. Let's do our analysis here. First of all, it grows from 5940 plus 3960, we get 9900 mile diameter. As the fourth Aeon collapses, the North Pole moves to Alaska, and there's a 99-mile diameter firmament that centers itself in the Alaskan North Pole at a city called Yakutat, Alaska. Here we have the megaliths that are very important. You've seen them in many movies, the Anton Island, Angkor Wat, Angkor Viejo, and most importantly, Easter Island, and Giza Pyramid, probably built at this time. Look at that circle, look where everything is located. The blue circle is the one you're looking at. Tribulation Point in Australia, Angkor Wat, in the various movies is all I'll say. Aeon number 5, 9900 miles in diameter. The blue circle. Remember, the firmament has energy. The energy comes up out of the earth and comes back down through the center of the North Pole. And this is where they have the power. Maybe it's how they get weightlessness at these edges, and that's how they were able to handle these big rocks. But we also know that they have giants at these times. So this also explains how the rocks were hewn. If you look at Franklin Graham's study, he'll point out that from the Alaska North Pole, Maybe that's the only North Pole that anyone's ever figured out that I know of. He figured out there's the 62-15-mile radius. You have all these discoveries of megaliths on that circle. And that's what started me to thinking that the North Pole actually moves. That gave me the idea to locate the Russian North Pole, one thing built on another. Scripture builds on scripture. God's wisdom builds on God's wisdom. All these graphs are developed by our ministry and show you the location of the megaliths and how they predict megaliths, because you can tell where a megalith should be by where the firmament is at the time. Keep in mind, many megaliths were submerged by the Noah's flood. Now let's get into Aeon number 6. Now let's look at the 6th firmament. 6th Aeon, rather. The megaliths built during this historical time are amazing, but more amazing the upper left-hand corner in the 3168 BC number, going to September 23, 2015. 3168 happens to be the Greek grammatica of the Lord Jesus Christ. Only God could work this out. And the 5776 is the beginning of the year 2016. You better start catching on. It's not that hard. During this time, the Antarctica pyramid was built. And most of you don't even know Antarctica has. There are presently fallen angels. The 200 remaining fallen angels still live in Antarctica. Why do you think we can't go there? We'd see them. We'd see their activities. We'd see the firmament. We'd see the undiscovered land that Mr. Admiral Byrd has described. The 5th firmament collapses and will expand it into the 6th firmament. That's where we live right now. It's a diameter of 15,840 miles in distance. There is no globe. If you take the globe live and you just unwrap the globe and flatten it out, you pretty much get what you're talking about. But you don't need a globe to do. Now remember, the giants came after the flood. It was Ham's wife, who we think brought the seed of Satan along after the flood. Giants exist today. They are the leaders of England. They're the ones that suppressed all the information about King Arthur and him winning all the battles. They're the Lancasters, the Bushmen, who are descendants of this group. They're the ones that took over the Federal Reserve along with Rothschild. They're the bad people. I used to worship the Bushes. Very, very bad and very demonic. Remember, if you want to Google Admiral Byrd, and you'll see Operation High Jump, Operation Deep Freeze, and you'll see that we were very busy in Antarctica before we knew what was down there. Once we knew what was down there, the United Nations quickly slapped a restriction, a ban from going to Antarctica. So now, Aeon 6 analysis relating to megaliths built during that time. We're now at Pisces, going into Aquarius. This is the time period we're at. Look at the Antarctic Aquarius. I was able to predict the exact location of the Antarctic. Notice that the United Nations also has quarantined the mountain and the location where the 200 fallen angels came to be. You better be watching these locations, because that's where Satan comes to the earth. Aeon 7, BNN, means the time of the end. God doesn't miss anything. It's all about grammatica. If you don't know the word grammatica, then you don't know the Bible. we didn't know it 5 years ago either. It's a process. Okay, now we have, here's the millennium time period. As the sixth firmament decays, we will enter a much bigger diameter area where we believe there's 33 continents. Or at least that's the number the Masons have read about, because 33 is their favorite. It will be a diameter of 25,740 miles in diameter, and the North Pole will be centered at the Russian North Pole. Here is the graphic of that situation, the center with our present continents and the outside, the 33 continents, which encompass it, and another ice wall protecting and incorporating and keeping the world's oceans intact. Remember, God's wristwatch now, counting down to the last days, moves from 2016 and to 2022. And that, my friends, is the last days. Here's a scaled map of the flat Earth. I don't think it's ever been done before. We will work on developing this during the last days, as I'm sure the YouTube will shut us off. And these will not be applicable for anyone to see. We'll be closed down for some bogus reason. And remember, the United Nations is taking over the internet, so they will have any reason that we go against homosexuality or whatever. It will close us down. Mega sweet spots defined. Let's talk about that. Fibonacci sequence is related to the Earth and aeon size, sweet spots, and outer firmament. When I say outer firmament, we have the normal firmament, and then there's a 5% increase. Allows you to show you where the firmament is. If you look at my Excel calculations here, you can see the numbers from 1980, and the outer firmament goes to 2072, etc., etc. This is the sweet spot where the megaliths are built. During the second aeon, the sweet spot and outer firmament relationship is blown up right here. The 2 is also 1980, but this sweet spot goes out to 2072. And this little sweet spot between the green and the black line is where all the megaliths are built during that time period. That's how we know the exact time period. Then we go to Aeon number 3, where we expand to 3960 and we move back to the North Pole center. We move to the Russian North Pole, and here the outer firmament is 4158, the inner firmament 3960. During that time, you see the Exxon pyramid being built. Hawaii is expanding. Giza could have been built. Chahokia probably built. The Sun Pyramid probably built. The Teotihuacan in Mexico definitely did. The giants were everywhere, and they lived for these firmament locations. They could get free energy. The energy that we could be using right now was available. Tesla knew that. Now we're in Aeon 5, and we expand to 9,900 mile diameter. But the sweet spot goes out to 10,358. Which is just a 5% increase. That is a lesson that I learned from the Giza Pyramid. If you take the missing capstone that's on our dollar bill, you'll figure out it's 5% for sure. Now, we look at this in Aeon 6. And we have the expansion from 9,900 to 15,840. Sure enough, we have an outer megalith dimension of 16,573, and this is where the megalith of the Antarctica pyramid is located. And that is located. And now you have the seventh millennium. And let's locate where the megaliths will be built. But we don't believe there'll be any giants left on the earth. And if there was, they would be building at 26,932 miles in diameter from the North Pole. Friends, this is amazing data, and this is the data that the Masons will kill for. They don't want you to know God loves you and He's right above you by 54,450 miles above you. The Giza Pyramid, indeed, is a total Earth replication of the flat Earth. The 5184 is truly an amazing degree. It relates to fire, it relates to power. It develops all the firmaments. God's sacred geometry so beats what man does. The squaring of the circle is not a demonic thing. It's God's way of defining the universe. When you take the circumference of the circle divided by 4, you get the size of the square that squares the circle with the 4 sides. Here we are led to the 10th firmament and God's throne. Here you can see the 5% that is taught in the pyramid. That's how you know what size the throne of God is. You've got to be astounded. Now you go down each firmament, you can tell the size of every throne in successive firmaments, all because of the 5%. See it, the 5%. Half of it, 2.5, there's the throne of God located. The throne of God moves. Just like they say the earth tilts, they kind of tell the truth, but they're not telling the exact truth. The firmament shifts 5 degrees. It doesn't shift 23.4. There it is right there at the Russian North Pole, third firmament. Now it's back to the center. And the fourth firmament. Remember 5940 in diameter. Then we go to the Alaskan North Pole, Yakutat, Alaska. And we expand to the 990. Now we come back to the present size of the flat Earth. The Antarctica Circle is our outside barrier at the sixth firmament and our 15840 in diameter. This step up. Keep our family pretty poor. We'd sure like to survive, but the scroll that rolls away is Revelation 6:14, described perfectly. Remember, the United Nations forbids travel to Antarctica by treaty, so you cannot see the pole. Admiral Byrd, our own admiral, controlled Operation High Jump when we freeze, and he told us all that is present in Antarctica and the lands that are outside it. He described them full of gold. Now, the actual biblical account of Noah, of this, truly is astounding. You'll see how the firmament is full of water. As above, as below, we have the oceans in the water, and we have the firmament above. And it is made of water. Noah entered the boat 47 days after Methuselah's death. All you have to do is study this, and it will come out. The first heaven, 990 miles in radius. Adam and Eve live right here. There's Mount Meru in side view, and the sixth firmament is where we are right now. And you see the firmament. When the sun shone through the firmament of Adam and Eve, the light that came through was pink. That's why the giants were so big and the trees were so big. And you see the sunken pyramids that are outside the firmament and the giant trees. Noah's flood came for 40 days and 40 nights. sun circled the firmament, and then rain and the Noah's boat went up to probably Mount Everest. Eve, rest. God called your help, teach us that. Eve, rest. Remember that, ever rest. When that first heaven fell away, all that water had to go somewhere. And each successive firmament between the first firmament and the sixth firmament also dissolved. Okay? So all that water flooded the sunken pyramids. That's why they're underwater in Japan and Cuba. And that's where the giant trees decayed. That's why you don't see the giant trees except as a mountain. Thank you so much for your time, and God bless you.